Volunteers. Dressed in uniforms of the 1880s and are preparing to perform a practice gun drill on one of the 32-pounder guns in the North Caponier. Each of the crew is first allotted a number. Number one commands, superintends the working of the breech mechanism, and lays the gun. Number two operates the breech mechanism, elevates and traverses. Number three sponges the gun, loads, elevates and traverses. Number four supplies number three with cartridges. Number five serves the vent, makes ready, and fires the gun. Number six supplies number four with cartridges.
Prepare for action!
Equipment needed to work the gun is brought out from a nearby artillery general store, and the gun is prepared for action. Wooden hand spikes for assisting the movement of the gun are placed to the rear, together with the sponge. The tampion is removed from the barrel of the gun. Tackles are attached to the carriage to assist with raising and lowering the gun along its sloping platform. The crew take up a safe position under cover, where they cannot be hit by enemy shot entering the gun port. The tackles are used to help lower the gun to its firing position. Its barrel projects out of the gun port. Checks the bore and the breech mechanism. The gun is now ready for action. This gun was designed to fire only case shots. The gun is pushed or pulled by hand. The wooden hand spikes are used.
Lower! Coin! Wait, screw! Elevate!
The smoke could make it difficult to aim, but the gun commander will continue to load and fire his gun even if he could not see the target.
Load!
The breech is opened and a case shot is inserted, which contained approximately 160 mixed metal balls. The cartridge is placed behind the case shot, and the gun is next laid for line. It traverses left or right on iron rails called racers that are set into the floor of the caponier. The wooden hand spikes are inserted at either side of the gun and the coin adjusted to give the correct elevation. The elevating screw is used for the final adjustment. Number 5 pushes a pricker down the vent to pierce the charge. He takes a friction tube from his pouch and inserts it in the vent. A lanyard is attached and he awaits the command to fire. After firing, the gun is sponged to clear the barrel of burning fragments. Number 5 places his thumb over the vent. This is called serving the vent. The tackles are attached and the gun is pulled back up its platform. All equipment is now returned to stores. The barrel is set at 4 degrees depression. The tampion is replaced to prevent moisture lodging in the barrel.
Stand up!